Abdelaziz from the UK.
So Sheikh, my question just pertains to the last fatra period between Isa alayhi salam and our messenger Ali wa salatu wa salam. I just wanted to ask about the fate of the of the Quraysh and other, you know, idol worshippers in Arabia at that time. Because, you know, obviously, Kufr and Shirk had become deep-rooted to the theology of the Arabs of the generations and generations from even their forefathers. And the Quraysh didn't know any better themselves. So will Allah Azza wa Jal forgive them and enter them into paradise?
Okay, I got your question, Abdelaziz. So Abdelaziz is asking about what is known as Ahlul Fatra, the people of the period. And some say that the mushriks, the idol worshippers of Quraysh, of Arabia, were part of the people of the period. Others disputed that and said, no, the people of the period are those who did not have any knowledge of prior messengers, nor contemporary ones, like the folks in Siberia or in Alaska or in the jungles of Africa, who had never heard of Christianity, Judaism, Islam, etc. So Allah says, وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. We were not going to torment and send with عذاب people without sending them a messenger to warn them, to educate them. So some folks say that the people of Quraysh had messengers before them. And that is Ibrahim and Ismail, and they had the Kaaba. So they knew monotheism, and they knew that there was only God, one Lord, Azza wa Jal, but they deviated. And they deviated the forms of worship to other than Allah, Azza wa Jal. Christianity and Judaism was there. It was in Najran, where they had Christians, and it was in Medina, where they had the tribes of the Jews. So they were exposed to other religions, yet they refrained and refused to believe in any of them and decided to worship their idols. So they, by default, are considered to be mushrikeen. Now, this is in Allah's hands, because such knowledge cannot be given to us. I wouldn't know if a woman in the midst of Champs-Élysées in Paris had received the knowledge of Islam. Maybe all the media, all the hype around Islam and those around her would not allow the name of Allah, the name of the Quran, the name of Muhammad to reach her ears, and hence she had no, I don't know. This is in Allah's hands. So we shouldn't pay a lot of attention to such things, whom we know that are in hell. We say that they are in hell, as the Prophet has told us, alayhi salam, when he was asked about his mother, about his father, etc. We know, and we say as the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Others, we have no knowledge of that, and Allah knows best.